Let me introduce myself. My name is Fox, S-P-A-R-K-S, Fox. I'm an ex-political prisoner. I spent 7 years here on Robben Island. I was charged in 1983 and released in 1990. My charge was terrorism under Section 29. So don't be afraid, I'm not going to terrorize you. I joined African National Congress and its military wing, Umkhonto weSizwe, the Spear of the Nation, in 1981. During that process, I was arrested. I was arrested for recruiting people to join the military wing of ANC, Umkhonto weSizwe. Sabotage, undergoing a military training, and in possession of unlawful arms, ammunition and explosives. You are free to take pictures. You are free to ask questions. So we are now in F section, one of the communal or general cells here on Robben Island. And I spent most of my 7 years in imprisonment in this cell. This cell was accommodating about 60 people, 6-0. We were forced to share that bathroom. Inside that bathroom, there are 3 showers. We were forced to wake up early in the morning at 4 a.m. in order to accommodate ourselves. If you didn't get a chance to wash, the authorities will lock you in solitary confinement. You will not eat the whole day, you will eat the following morning. And during those years, we had to wash thrice a week, during Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays. The other 4 days, there was no water here on Robben Island. And we had to wash with cold water, even during the winter season. And also, inside this cell, there are 2 intercom radios. These 2 intercom radios were used to gather the information inside the cells. If you are discussing something politically, the authorities will come in and victimize us. In order to stop that victimization, we decided to cover these 2 intercom radios with blankets and put boxes so that the authorities cannot hear what we were discussing. People like Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela spent 18 years here on Robben Island, sleeping on the floor, using those 2 beds. And there were no beds, no sheets, no pillows. They were eligible to receive only 3 blankets. 2 blankets were used to replace a sheet and a pillow. So they were allowed to sleep with 1 blanket, even during the winter season. And during those years, there were no glasses inside those window frames. And the rain will come through inside the cells. Here in Cape Town during winter season, there's a lot of rain. It's very cold and windy. Other people got the TB and W pneumonia. And when they got out of this prison, they died. And the ex-political prisoners went on a hunger strike for many days without food, demanding that, and the authorities responded after 15 days, where all political prisoners were allowed to get bed. As political prisoners, we were segregated here on Robben Island. There were colored political prisoners, Asian political prisoners, and black political prisoners, all the male political prisoners. Female political prisoners were locked in Kronstadt prison in mainland, and white political prisoners were locked in Pretoria prison, also in mainland. We were segregated on clothes and wearing. The colored and Asian political prisoners were allowed to wear the long sleeve shirts, long trousers, with socks, shoes, and a jacket. But the black political prisoners were allowed to wear the short sleeve shirts, short trousers, with no socks, no shoes, no jackets, even during the winter season. People like Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela spent 18 years here on Robben Island with no socks, no shoes, no jacket. And also, we were segregated on that scale. That was the dire scale that was given to us as political prisoners. So colored and Asian political prisoners, on mil-mil, they were given 6 ounces, which is 200 grams. And black political prisoners were given 12 ounces, which is 400 grams. On bread, colored and Asian political prisoners were given 4 ounces, and black political prisoners were not allowed to receive bread. They were allowed to receive puza manja drink, the so-called energy drink. But it had never gave us any energy. Jam or syrup, colored and Asian political prisoners were given 1 ounce, and black political prisoners were not allowed to receive jam or syrup. And during our arrival as political prisoners, we were given the new names. As I have already mentioned that my original name is Fox, but during my arrival, I was given another name. As all political prisoners who recently arrived on Robben Island, like Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela, had never been called Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela. I myself was called 5683. And Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela was called 46664. And we were given a yellow card. On that yellow card, they will write your new name. That was the yellow card that was given to us as political prisoners during our arrival. But it was not big like this one. It was a very small card that you can put inside your pocket. That was the yellow card of Billy Naya, who was serving a 20 years imprisonment here on Robben Island. And he was charged for sabotage. And his new name was 6964. So Robben Island consists of 7 sections. There is a section for those who recently arrived on Robben Island, who will stay for a period of 6 months in solitary confinement. There is also B section for those who are considered the leaders of the organizations. People like Nelson Mandela, Walter Sisulu, Clarence Makwetu, Mac Maharaj, and others. And also there is C section, which was used as a punishment section. If you have done something wrong here on Robben Island, you will be locked in those single cells in C section, where they will punish you. And also there is D section for those who were arrested in Namibia, who were led by Toivo, yeah, Toivo. They were brought here on Robben Island to serve their sentences. There is also EFG sections. Those are the communal or general cells like this cell. So now, let's proceed to Mandela's cell number 7.